Oxytocin is often mislabeled as the love hormone, but it's responsible for a wide range of biological processes, so some researchers are starting to use the hormone as medicine. Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Oxytocin is often cited as being responsible for a crazy little thing called love. It's a hormone with this chemical structure. It's made in the brain in the hypothalamus and is secreted by the pituitary gland, and lots of things increase our body's production of it, not just love. It's more accurate to call it the social hormone. Yes, it's released in both sexes during climax, but it also performs a wide variety of social functions. It bonds mothers to their children. It's released when women breastfeed their babies, but it's also released when we look at our dogs. And it also plays a role in fear and anxiety, which we've talked about in another episode. So it does so much more than make us fall in love. It can also be used as medicine. It's been used to induce labor and control bleeding of childbirth for years, but it can help in so many other ways. It may even help sober us up. Well, it definitely sobers rats up. In a study published in the Journal of the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, researchers got rats drunk and made them do a sobriety test to test their coordination. One group of rats was given a dose of oxytocin along with their alcohol, while the other group had alcohol alone. The researchers found that the rats with oxytocin retained the full use of their coordination skills, even while drunk. The oxytocin sobered up the rats by acting on the same receptors in the brain as alcohol, the delta subunit GABA A receptors. When alcohol acts on these receptors, it blocks the brain's ability to fine-tune motor control. But oxytocin doesn't work on other receptors that alcohol affects, so you would still feel inebriated. The researchers wondered whether or not oxytocin would be a good mechanism for a new type of drug that could work with alcohol-related disorders, but they were worried that a drug that stopped people from getting sloppy drunk would only encourage more drinking. Oxytocin as medicine would be more than just a drinking buddy, though. It could actually help people make more buddies. Making friends is hard for anyone, but many people who live with psychiatric disorders especially struggle with social situations. One small study also published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences found that oxytocin could help. The study found that one sniff of an oxytocin nasal spray improved brain function in some children with autism. While a deficiency of oxytocin isn't a specifically autism-related trait, levels of oxytocin vary naturally from person to person. In this study, researchers gave participants a nasal spray filled with oxytocin or a placebo. Those who got the oxytocin spray showed greater brain activity in the regions associated with rewards and emotion recognition when performing a social task. Basically, their brains rewarded them more when they participated in social tasks than those who just had the placebo spray. Oxytocin can even help those who suffer from phobias. According to a study published in the journal Biological Psychiatry, most people are afraid of something like spiders or heights. Maybe you were bit by a dog when you were a kid and now you're terrified of them. That's what psychologists call conditioning. But now your girlfriend has a dog and, well, you'd like to get over that fear. That's going to take a little reconditioning. The traditional approach is to expose a patient to their fear gradually over time and in a safe environment. That way the alarm system in their brain can learn to calm down. It can learn there's no real threat around that fear. This overwriting of the memory is called extinction. But extinction is a long and hard process. There's the trauma, being exposed to the fear, and a risk of relapses. But oxytocin makes that overwriting process go a little faster. In this study, researchers created a fear response in participants by giving them a little electric shock when they looked at a certain picture. Brain scans revealed that this created a fear response in their brain every time they saw the picture. The researchers then gave half the participants a nasal spray of oxytocin and the other half a placebo. And then the researchers overwrote the fear memory by showing them the picture without the shock. They found that the fear center of the brain, the amygdala, showed less activity in those who got oxytocin than those who got the placebo. But before you run off and try to fix your fears with oxytocin, researchers from Concordia University's Center for Research in Human Development caution not to use it off-label because it can cause less than desired other effects. If you want to boost your mood, there's no medicine like telling that special person in your life how much they mean to you. K Jewelers can help you do just that. Every kiss begins with K. As for those less desired other effects, oxytocin doesn't just cause warm and fuzzy feelings. In one study, researchers found it can lead people to be overly sensitive to other people's emotions, which isn't always a good thing. They give the example of your boss being uncomfortable in their chair and making a face. And if you're overly sensitive thanks to oxytocin, you might think that face was about you. Oxytocin can also increase the strength of memories of negative social situations and increase fear and anxiety. So if you have questions about the dark side of the so-called love hormone, check out this video right here.
The ERK is an important part of how we regulate fear in our brains, and it appears that oxytocin activates it for even longer, which ultimately makes it harder to recover from the negative experience that you had.
So would you ever take oxytocin, or have you? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.